We first see what Sisi Nakaze is doing in the backyard. This grass can grow in hours if properly propagated. The production of engineered bamboo primarily starts at this nursery, where a variety of the grass are grown. Nakaze makes sure as many shoots come out before they can be transferred to a plantation. It's her job. She says bamboo has helped her raise her child, provided money for rent, and she can put food on the table. I didn't have a job before, but now I earn enough to buy something to eat. I pay school fees and worry less. It has helped me. Once they mature, the bamboo poles are sliced into tiny strips that are glued together to make beams. Typically replacing wood, these bamboo pieces go beyond timber. This processing facility outside Kampala is making corrugated roofing sheets, tiles, and even fiberglass.
It's a very highly industrializable raw material. Okay, so where others see a round tube of bamboo, the culm, for us we see timber, for example. And this being a very fast growing, it's the fastest growing thing on earth. Okay. Bamboo has been rumored, and we are beginning to see this. Some species of bamboo can grow up to 90 centimeters. That's 1.5 feet per day.
Many years ago, places like Kasese had bamboo grown along riverbanks and lake shores to hold water. Young men would make or carve out shakers from bamboo poles used when they go grazing. Using the poles for construction of temporary houses is time immemorial, and in Mbale, for example, bamboo is food, locally called malewa. But now with advancing technology and ever-growing demand for construction materials, people have been pushed to use bamboo as an alternative.
We want our steel from grass, your timber from grass, to replace the less sustainable species of the hardwoods, which take 20, 25, 40 years to grow. This grows in just a few years, and that speaks to the sustainability. However, to your point of the value chain, we need tons of this material.
These lightweight, sophisticated bamboo products make their way to Europe, where a startup is using high-tech processing to transform them into thin fibers that are glued together to make material used for cars, aeroplanes, and windmills.
We now have a client that makes materials for cars, airplanes, windmills, a very lightweight, strong material, which looks very much like fiberglass. But instead of using glass fiber mats, they use bamboo fiber mats. And instead of using petrol-based epoxy or resin, they used bio-based resin to put it together. The outcome is just like glass fiberglass, a very lightweight, very strong material.
Bamboo's tensile is stronger than that of steel, which is why it's being considered for reinforcement in construction. Taga Nuagaba took up growing bamboo as a business, but says farmers need support.
You'll have to wait for like 3 to 4 years, and after that you'll be harvesting every year, because the shoots that come from the established rhizomes grows and matures in a year, and you can harvest it in 2 years. You can harvest it, and you shouldn't harvest it after 4 years. It's too weak that time. So it grows very fast. And when you look at the strength of the timber that you make out of bamboo compared to mvule, mesopsis emni, pine, eucalyptus, bamboo still remains superior.
The team here is working days to produce a container of strips, but that requires 5,000 poles per month to meet the demand. In Uganda, commercial plantations are still few and young, so their biggest challenge at the moment is access to bamboo. In a country where proper hardwood is becoming scarce, this grass is closing the gap slowly. Yes, bamboo poles come in different shapes and sizes, which makes calculation during production difficult. Engineered bamboo is solving this problem. I'm Razia Athman.